Hey guys, welcome in Mastering Angular 15 from Beginners to Advanced course. In today's lecture, we will talk about the custom reactive forms validation. Custom validators are necessary when built-in validators don't meet your requirements. For example, work email invalidation, email that doesn't come from public email services such as Gmail, Yahoo, and Hotmail. And we can validate our work email by using custom validators. First, let's see the theoretical process of creating custom validators. And for that, we need validator fn is an interface representing a validation function. This function takes an abstract control and returns either null or a validation error object. Abstract control is a class that serves as a base for form control, form group, and form array. It provides properties and methods used for validation. This is our student form in which we are already working. And here we need to apply the custom validation on this email field. If you see my previous lecture, then you already know that I have already implemented two validations. One is for required email and one is for validation of email. Now what we want that this email field only validate our work email, but not the public emails like Gmail, Yahoo, etc. And for that we need to create our custom validation. And this is our email field in our TS file. And as you can see, we implemented already required an email validator. Next, I'm going to create a validator which will validate only my work email but not the public ones. And for that, I'm going to write a function. And its name should be work email validator, which will return validator fn. And it will return control abstract control of type validation error or null, and it will be a lambda expression. And first I'm going to get the value of my control. For that we need to write const email is equal to control dot value. And in this email variable, we will get the value which user pass in the email field. And now I'm going to extracting the domain from this email. Next, we need to define the public domain. And for that, const public domain. And in this, what I'm going to define is gmail.com, yahoo.com and ymail.com. Next, I need to check which domain is invalid, and for that I'm going to write this variable invalid. And in this I'm going to check public domain.includes domain. If we have any public domain in this email, it will store in this invalid variable. And if we get any value in invalid, then our work email is true. Otherwise, it will be null. So in this case, when work email true, we will store our validation error. So this is the way we can define our custom validation. Now we need to use this validation exactly like we are using others. Now let's apply it in email form control. And here I will use this function, this.workEmailValidator. Now if I want to write the validation error for the front end, then I will use this work email value in HTML file. As we already have written two validation errors, one is email is required and second is email is invalid. Exactly like this, I'm going to write for the custom validation. Let's copy it. And I'm going to write the value of this validation error, that was work email, and its message will be please enter work email. Now let's run the application and see it on the front end. And this is our email field. First, if we click but not enter the value, then we have this validation error, email is required. Then it will show an error, email is invalid if we are not enter correct email. As you know, I have entered this custom email co.com. That's why it's not showing any error. But if I enter any public email like Gmail or Yahoo, it will show our custom validation error message. And this is the way we can implement our custom validators. Hope you understand it. Now if we see the summary, then custom validators in Android give us the flexibility to implement complex validation logic that built-in validators can't handle. Second, they are functions that take a form control and return either null or an error object. Also, we can display error messages in our templates based on the error objects returned by our custom validators. And this was the today's lecture. Hope you understand it. If you have any question or query, you can ask in comments. But if this lecture is helpful for you, then guys, please like, subscribe, and share my channel. Thanks for watching.